看到呢，班上有很多的空座位，像这个班呢，他们总共是29个人，但是今天只有10个小朋友到学校上课，也就是有将近2/3的人都是请防疫假的。那即将迎来疫情高峰期，台北市决定呢，从5月23号到5月27号呢，国小、国中、高中职呢，授权各学校可以全面的采取远距教学，就是为了避免疫情快速扩散。
As we see here, just within one class, there is a teacher who is teaching from home, students who are taking epidemic prevention leaves and learning from home, and others who are still coming to the campus. Starting this week, Taipei has announced that all classes can be conducted remotely.
远距一周的话，就是应该是99.99%是会在家里吧。目前是没有申请说要在学校的。
Although this change will enhance the safety of children, many families who have parents who both go to work will have to make adjustments accordingly to make sure that someone can be at home to take care of the children.
其实家长就是还蛮两难的，因为会考量到说可能去上学会有那个染疫的风险，但是像我本身就是职业妇女，也考量到要上班，所以就是在这方面其实是还蛮纠结的。
As many children in Taiwan have yet to get vaccinated, parents need to be extra careful because according to Dr. Li Jianzhang at the NTU hospital, the Omicron variant is especially brutal when it comes to children.
这一次的 Omicron 最主要就是攻击我们的气管。那这个小朋友的气管就像小指一样这么细。所以当气管发炎的时候，它塞住了会造成很严重的呼吸困难。有时候我们叫做哮吼。或者是细支气管炎，都是这次 Omicron 呢特别在小朋友会造成比较严重病情的一个原因。香港也观察到类似的一个现象，那这是比较特别的啊，因为在欧美比较少这种 Omicron 产生小朋友的脑炎，所以呢，这个我们在东方族群的小朋友呢也要特别注意这样的一个发展。
According to a study done in Hong Kong, with around 1,000 children hospitalized during the outbreak of the Omicron variant, the mortality rate was 0.35%, 7 times more than that of a common influenza. Doctors are reminding all that this virus is not a regular flu. Young children and elders in the family will need to be paid special attention to, as the epidemic will continue to worsen in the country.
死亡率我们原先最早大概一个月前差不多2%，那现在已经升到3.7%了，就是死亡率有慢慢在攀升。那主要原因就是老人家，特别是高龄或者80岁以上的族群，这个死亡率最高。现在其实最重要就是把这个高龄的80岁以上的老人家，或者有慢性病啊、高风险因素的这些老人家，我们把它顾好，那降低死亡率。那我们的疫情其实就这个共存的之路就可以走过大概成功一半。另外一半就是医疗量能不要崩盘。
With cases at an all-time high in the country, a large number of the medical staff in northern Taiwan have also been diagnosed. Medical resources are running tight in the country at the moment, so citizens need to do their best to protect themselves, stay away from crowded places, and make sure to get vaccinated. TVBS English News.